Hello students, welcome once again to this video series. In this video series we have been seeing the derivations of the first lesson, electric charges and fields in physics of CBSE board syllabus. And today we are going to see the 11th derivation. Before that I would like to say something. Subscribe this channel, share it with your friends and click the bell icon so that you would get notifications as and when we upload the videos. Okay, come on, let us move on to the derivation. Electric field intensity due to infinitely long two thin plane sheets of opposite charges. Here there are two thin plane sheets are given. They are infinitely long and moreover they have got opposite charges. So due to these plane sheets we are going to find out the electric field intensity within these sheets and also outside these sheets. Before that, let us have a close look on the diagram so that we will get a clear idea of it. Here comes a sheet with positive charge and here comes a sheet with negative charge. I have marked three points here, P1 outside the sheets and here P2, point number 2, which lies in between these two sheets, and P3. Which lies outside the sheet. So the points P1 and P3, they lie outside the sheets and the point P2 lie within the sheets, I mean in between the sheets. Now what about the direction of electric field? We all know that electric field lines originate from positive charge and they terminate at negative charge. So as per this sheet, its electric field lines go radially outward. As far as this sheet is concerned, the electric field lines, they terminate at this sheet, so they come towards this sheet. So in the case of point number 1, P1, what about the electric field due to this sheet? It is in this direction, so that it is marked as E plus vector. And what about the electric field due to this sheet? Forget about this sheet. Due to this sheet. Here I am going to calculate the electric field at this point. So here I have placed the test charge. So it's a positive in nature. So this plane sheet attracts this positive charge. So what happens? The electric field lines are directing towards the sheet. So here I have written E minus vector. Similarly, in the case of P3, here also I have taken this point as P3. Here the electric field due to this sheet is directing towards in this direction. And the electric field due to this sheet is directing towards the sheet because it attracts the positive charge. We have taken in this way. In other words, electric field lines always come towards the sheet as it is negative in nature. So the electric field is directing in this direction. So I have written E minus vector. Now let us come to the point which lies in between these two sheets. This is the point. Here is what we are going to calculate the electric field. What about the electric field direction due to this sheet? It goes outward from this sheet. So this is the direction of the electric field due to this sheet. And what about the electric field direction due to this sheet? electric field lines come towards the sheet. So again, here also the electric field direction pointing in this direction. So altogether, in the case of this point, both the direction of the electric fields due to this sheet and also due to this sheet are directing towards in the same direction. So they get added up. In the case of P1 and P3, they get cancelled up because they are equal in magnitude and opposite in directions. So here they get cancelled up and also here they get cancelled up. So the electric field in these two points is zero. So we have got electric field only in the points which lie in between these two sheets. So with the diagram, I have explained to some extent. Now let us see the derivations. Electric field intensity due to an infinitely large plane sheet. We have already seen the derivation. So electric field intensity due to an infinitely large plane sheet is nothing but E is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Here, P1 and P3 are located outside the plane sheets. Therefore, electric field intensity E is equal to E plus vector plus E minus vector. So for this electric field, I have written sigma by 2 epsilon naught, but this vector is equal in magnitude but opposite in direction, so that I have given the minus sign for this. So here minus sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So what happens? Plus and minus, they get cancelled and the electric field becomes zero where outside the plane sheets. Next one, P2 lies inside the plane sheets. Here E plus vector and E minus vector are in the same direction. So electric field intensity E is equal to E plus vector plus E minus vector. As they are in the same direction, so they get the same signs. So sigma by 2 epsilon naught plus sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Here I have taken this 2 epsilon naught as the LCM. So sigma plus sigma is equal to 2 sigma by 2 epsilon naught. 2 get cancelled. So I get the final expression as E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. So this is the electric field intensity at a point which lies in between the plane sheets which are infinitely long and oppositely charged. So with this, this derivation has come to an end. Let us meet with another derivation in the next video.
Like, share and comment and subscribe our channel and click the bell button for more videos. Thank you.